past 50 years, thousands of men in the UK have donated sperm. 53-year-old Luke was a donor as a young man, helping couples to start families. He now wants to come forward and discover if he may have any biological sons or daughters looking for their donor father.
Thirty years ago, I was a sperm donor. For about 4 years, I donated sperm. And recently, well, I suppose life events, it gave me a bit of time to think, and I thought I'd try and find out if anything had happened. Because when I first started donating, it was totally anonymous, and there's no way of even tracing it, apart from possibly DNA.
And that's why we're here.
Yeah.
How old were you when you first gave sperm?
19.
We're here now.
Yeah.
Why?
Because I'd spoken to a lot of people who never found out who their real parents or their biological parents were or whatever. And it always troubled them. And I just thought, well, there's people out there that would probably just like to know. If I can give them that, and if I can give them that before anything happens to me. I think I'm ready to open this door right now. It could change my life.
Hello, come on in.
Hi.
Hello, it's lovely to see you again.
Nice to see you again, yeah.
Okay, So when I first met you, it was because you wanted to find out if you had any sperm donor children. Mm. And that was because you had donated sperm hundreds of times in the 1980s when you were at university. So we know that so far there's been only around 200 men
who have come forward, who have lifted their right to anonymity.
Right, that's a tiny number, yes.
Yeah. You know, you are part of a very unique group of men.
So there was always going to be two shots at finding any donor-conceived children. And the first was to upload your DNA to the worldwide databases. And when we looked through all of these databases, not a single person was on there who looks like they are your donor child.
Yeah.
But that was going to be just, you know, a route. Mm. But the main thing was actually to go on the donor conceived register and make yourself available for any donor conceived children who were looking for you. So the results are in, and we've got an email from the donor conceived register. But only you can open it.
Right.
You ready?
Okay.
So let me give you this. So there you go. So it's just there.
Just open this.
Just take your time.
Comparison of your sample with the current donor-conceived individuals has not revealed a link. I'm aware that this may be disappointing for you, but we will continue to compare your sample with all new registrants and will write to you if we have any positive findings in the future.
So no children on the donor-conceived register. It's not that you don't have donor-conceived children out there. It's hugely possible that you could have dozens of donor-conceived children.
Yeah.
They may not know that they are donor conceived, because the only way they're going to know is if their parents have told them. Equally, you can have people who know that they're donor conceived and they're completely relaxed about the whole thing. They don't feel a need at this point to find anything further. They may do in the future. They may never feel the need to find out. It's early days, really early days. So it could easily be that you have dozens of children out there. They're not yet on the donor-conceived register, and that register is growing all of the time. give it a few months and you get an email.
Yeah, that was something that was occurring to me more and more over that this is kind of a lifetime thing. It may be that I'm 80 and someone will come up and go, excuse me.
Yeah, it's one of those things. So though it hasn't turned out quite how we would have hoped, that is actually the reality, I suppose, of genetic testing.
Yeah. I was always happy with either result, to be honest with you.
I'm cool with that. I mean, that's what it was all for.